It's another wonderful day in City 17, or at least you think it is. Truth is, ever since you started drinking Dr. Breen's Private Reserve, you really can't remember if you've ever had a bad day before in your life. Then again, you can't remember much about your old life anyway, because just like any career-focused Combined Civil Protection Force member, you opted in for the memory erasure just in order to ensure fast promotion. Who needs personal memories when you're raking in all that sweet, sweet moolah? Besides, you think you like your life much better now, at least it's quieter, and you seem to vaguely recall something about evil spirits, possessed girlfriends, and throwing said girlfriends out of cliffs or out of windows. Oh well, new alien overlords, new you. As you watch from your post on City 17's train station, the latest citizen transfer train rolls in. Oh boy, you sigh to yourself, more goobers from other cities come to see the glory that is the Citadel. Well, you resolve to rough up a few of them, whether they've authorized transfer tickets or not. A Civil Protection Force officer who beats is a Civil Protection Force officer who cares. You watch the citizens exiting their train cars and can't help but overhear one of them as he looks over his shoulder at another citizen and says, "Hey, I didn't see you board. That's strange." Strange indeed. Could this be a stowaway? Impossible. No human could survive the harsh conditions outside of the cities. You decide you'd better check it out and make your way over. The mystery man looks, well, rather unassuming. Kind of like a nerdish book type, really. He's got a goatee and thick black glasses. Goatees are so pre-7-hour war. What a total nerd. As you approach him, you knock over an empty aluminum can and instruct a stranger to pick it up. It's so pathetic the way citizens always do. Terror that you might shoot them in the face if they disobey in their eyes. Because, of course, you might actually shoot them in the face. That reminds you, you have to check in later with your supervisors on exactly how many humans you're allowed to kill now. With the suppression field up, nobody's had a kid in decades and, well, much like the rest of Earth's resources, humanity is becoming a rapidly diminishing resource. The citizen, though, looks down at the can and, well, you can't believe it, he hesitates. There's something in his eyes, something defiant. It's almost like he hasn't lived the last 20 years in an oppressive police state overseen by alien rulers from another dimension. You go to teach this citizen a lesson when suddenly one of your fellow officers steps in, informs you that this one is wanted for questioning. You offer your services, nothing makes a day better than some random beatings, but the officer declines, says he can handle it himself. You watch this goateed stranger walk away and shrug your shoulders. Now he's somebody else's problem. You've got enough on your plate already with random beatings, the occasional shooting, and of course, avoiding being transferred off-world. You shudder at the thought death is a better fate than being sent to one of the Combine's other worlds. A while later, in what seems like a half-life to you, there's alarms and your supervisor screaming in your ear. This goateed man has escaped and whoever he is a very high priority target. You mutter a curse and start booking it, thinking about the hell that poor sucker who let him get away is gonna be stationed at whenever this is all over. So you decided to join the Combine's transhuman military and give up your liberty to become a brutal thug for an interdimensional empire. And now Gordon Freeman has shown up to absolutely ruin your day. How in the world are you gonna fight and defeat the most dangerous man in any dimension? Dr. Gordon Freeman is an MIT-trained theoretical physicist whose expertise is pressing buttons and pulling levers. That, of course, is when he's not busy kicking alien ass all over two different dimensions. Freeman was originally assigned to the Black Mesa Research Facility, where a resonance cascade during a teleportation experiment ended up accidentally opening up a portal to the alien world of Zen. The incident prompted a military invasion of the Black Mesa facility in order to contain and clean up the threat posed by the alien creatures. Ever resourceful, Freeman was forced to fight for his life against both interdimensional aliens and human military forces. Despite having no weapons experience, Freeman quickly developed a proficiency in small arms, becoming a crack shot with multiple weapons. However, his expertise extended into even heavy weapons, such as shoulder-fired anti-armor weapons and explosives. Basically, an alien invasion forced Gordon Freeman to become a nerd Rambo. Upon Freeman's return to Earth, thanks to the intervention of the mysterious G-Man, he's come home to discover a world that has been overrun and is now ruled by aliens from another dimension. Needless to say, Freeman is more than a little pissed, and along with his trusty crowbar, he's aiming to turn this alien invasion around and set the people of Earth free. For you, though, this means that you'll be out of a job. And though you can't quite remember your past, you know for a fact that you don't want to go back to what you think was a life of battling evil demons and spirits who possess your girlfriends and force you to yeet them out open windows. This free man must be stopped. And besides, you've invested so much into the Combine's 401k plan already. Taking down Freeman is not going to be an easy task, most notably because every time that you and your fellow Combine soldiers get so close to doing so, he seems to have a number of lucky interventions. Even when trapped in a certain death scenario, Freeman's own personal guardian angel, the enigmatic G-Man, seems to swoop in at the nick of time and teleport him away. How in the world are you going to fight that? Well, you could try and use Combine technology, but despite being an extremely advanced alien race, the Combine are actually pretty terrible at teleporting, and can't even teleport between two places in the same universe. They can only move between universes. And then, of course, there's that pesky DOG machine that keeps swooping in to save Gordon. A giant quadruped robot, the thing must have been built out of trash, but man, can it take a beating. You've personally watched Freeman blow countless gunships out of the sky, and yet even your heavy weapons don't seem to do much but occasionally slow down, dog. Honestly, you're starting to wonder why the Combine just doesn't copy the design. And why in the world is some young human engineer working with literal trash doing a better job of building murder machines than the intergalactic alien empire? Screw it, you'll just jump into the fray and overwhelm Freeman with numbers. After all, there's literally millions of your fellow Combine soldiers, and countless other soldiers can be teleported in from other Combine worlds if you really need them. And there's like, what, 60 human rebels left? This will be a walk in the park. And you and your fellow evil alien overlord transhuman core chuckle to yourselves as you ride an APC to the battle. Except as soon as you exit the vehicle, one of your buddies gets immediately gunned down. You rush for a covering position and watch as another squad member drops. Roaring in anger, you pop up from behind your cover and open fire on Freeman, but watch as the bullets literally ping off his armor. Meanwhile, like three shots from his rifle drops yet another one of your buddies. You're seriously starting to have some second thoughts about this whole Combine business. Why in the world is this scruffy human resistance able to build better armor for its soldiers than the freaking intergalactic alien empire? What, did the Combine also invade the Star Wars universe and get the guy who makes stormtrooper armor to design its military forces armor? Well, screw it, you're not going to sit here and get turned to Swiss cheese for an evil alien empire that can't even build better body armor than some pathetic human resistance members, or make better war robots than some girl can manage to do with a pile of junkyard trash. You throw your rifle down and surrender, because clearly there's no beating Gordon Freeman in this dimension, and even if you did, well, you can't beat his G-Man guardian angel, and neither can your alien overlords. Hey, you might have failed to take down the legendary Gordon Freeman, but maybe you want to know how to take down the evil Freddy Fazbear instead. Click on this video here, or perhaps you'd enjoy this other video instead. Either way, click one right now, because unlike Valve, we won't make you wait 20 years for a sequel.